Welcome back to Gate Baba. This is the problem solving session 2 on arc welding. Okay, start with the problems. Penetration is increased by increasing welding current and decreasing welding speed. Why? Because if I increase the welding current, what will happen? The heat supply will be increased. Heat supply is given by Vi divided by Av times of heat transfer efficiency. So if heat supply increases, then the penetration will also get increases. So how can I do that? Whether I have to increase the voltage or I have to increase the current. From the options, the welding current. So welding current has to be increased. And now come to velocity. Velocity having inverse relationship with heat supplied. So it has to be decreased to give more heat supply. If I give more heat, then only the penetration is increases. So decreasing of welding speed. And that is the correct answer. Now come to the second question. In DC welding, the straight polarity results in, we know DCSP means 1/3 of heat will be at electrode and 2/3 of heat will be at workpiece. Okay, what are the answers? Lower penetration, no. Low deposition rate, yes, it is correct. Okay, that means electrode is not melting fastly when compared to DCRP. So the deposition rate is very low in DCSP. Okay. Now come to the next question. The electrodes used in arc welding are coated. This is not expected to provide a protective atmosphere to weld. Yes, it is correct. In stabilize arc, yes, we are using the coatings for stabilizing the arc. And add alloying elements, yes, this is also correct. And prevent electrode from contamination, yes, this is wrong. So our option is D. We are not using the coatings to prevent electrode from contamination. So not to expect means this is our answer. These three are the functions of coatings and this is not a function. Okay, and then come to the next question. Preheat before welding is done too. Okay, sorry, this question is misplaced here. This is a gas welding question. By the way, just know the answer. In gas welding, I will explain it again. So prevent plate distortion. Okay, just know that. I will explain this question again in gas welding. Okay. Now come to the next question. Two plates of same metal having equal thicknesses are to be butt welded with electric arc. When the plate thickness changes, welding is achieved by adjusting the current, adjusting the duration of current, changing the electrode size and changing the electrode coating. No, the answer is adjusting the current. If I increase the current, I can get more penetration. If I decrease the current, I get less penetration. This is our first question, indirect question. Okay, the question is same as first question, no need to explain again. And which of the following arc welding processes does not use consumable? So here it is non-consumable. Does not use means non-consumable electrode. In each process, TIG welding, that means gas tungsten arc welding, nothing but TIG. Tungsten is very costly material and very high melting point material also. We don't want to lose that again and again. So that's why we are using DCSP current in TIG welding. So non-consumable electrode means TIG welding process. That is nothing but GTA. Okay. And then next to 2 1 mm thick steel sheets are to be spot welded at a current of 5000 amperes, assuming effective resistance to be 200 micro ohms and current flow time of 0.2 seconds. Heat generated during the process will be, again it is a misplaced question here, it is question of resistance welding, by mistaken it is placed here. Okay, we will solve this question very easily. We know that the heat generated Q equals I square RT. The units of I must be amperes and the resistance units must be in ohms. And T units must be in seconds. So from this data, 200 micro ohms. So we have to convert resistance micro ohms to ohms. That means R equals 200 times 10 power minus 6 ohms. So just substitute the values, you will get answer. I is nothing but 5000 square times R is 200 times 10 power minus 6. Time is given as 0.2. So if I solve this question, I will get 1000 joules. And there is a tip here: without solving the question, without substituting data, we can tell the answer very easily. No welding process can be done at these minimum values of energy: 0.2 joule, 1 joule, 5 joule. These are nothing. We cannot do anything with this amount of energy. So we require high energy. That means 1000 joules. So it is the only option having high energy. Okay. So directly we can answer this question without solving that. And then come to the next question. In an arc welding butt joint, okay, the welding speed is to be selected such that, so welding speed is to be selected, that means we have to find the welding speed such that highest cooling rate is achieved. Okay, melting efficiency and heat transfer efficiency are, melting efficiency is given 50% and heat transfer efficiency is given as 70%. Okay, the area of weld cross section is 5 mm square. Area also given as 5 mm square. Okay, and unit energy required to melt the metal is, heat required to melt, that is nothing but HM in our notation, 10 joule per mm cube. Okay, if the welding power is 2 kilowatts, so the power is given, welding power is 2 kilowatts, so I am converting this to 2000 joule per second. Okay, the welding speed, so V is how much, the power input is nothing but VI, but we know that for heat supplied the units must be in joule per mm cube. So how can I get the joule per mm cube units for this power? Just divide the power with volume flow rate, then you will get this units. Okay, so the power supplied is nothing but the heat supplied. Okay, so that means the heat supplied equals 2000 joules per second divided by volume flow rate. Volume flow rate is nothing but area times of velocity, AV, continuity equation. Okay, remember that AV, mm cube per second, second will get cancelled and you will get relation as 2000 divided by, A is given as 5 and velocity we have to find out, joule per mm cube. Now these are all in our required units. Now what is the formula for melting efficiency? Heat required to melt divided by heat supplied. Okay, but heat supplied efficiency is 70% only, so it has to multiply it by 0.7. so now substitute all the values from this equation. Melting efficiency is given as 50%, so that means 0.5 equals heat required to melt is 10. Okay, and then heat supplied is 2000 divided by 5V times of heat transfer efficiency is 0.7. If I solve this, I will get velocity equals 14 mm per second, and that is our required answer. So see the options, yes it is there, and option C, B is correct, sorry, 14 mm per second. Okay, if you know the units, then you can directly solve the question. So please be careful by units. Okay, and then come to the next question. It is a match the following question. We use cellulose coating for gas formation. That means if I add coating material as cellulose to electrode, then it will form some shielding gases. So A is matched with 4, A4, and rutile coating. So rutile coating is nothing but titanium oxide, so it will form a slag layer over the weld zone, and it is used to form slag. That means B is matched with 3. Okay, and then come to third one, iron powder. Iron powder is just alloying agent, there is no specific reason for that, and C is matched with 1, and the left one is basic coating. Basic coating is for absorbing the gases, so D is matched with 2. Okay, the key point in this question you have to remember is rutile coating is nothing but titanium oxide. It is also called as titania. Okay, and it is used to form the slag over the weld zone to protect from the atmospheric gases. Okay, very important question. And then come to the next question. The voltage arc length characteristics of DC arc is given by V equals 20 plus 40 L, where L is arc length in centimeter, and the power source characteristics can be approximated by a straight line. Open circuit is 80 volts and short circuit current is 1000 amperes, and VO is given as 80 volts and IS is given as 1000 amps. The optimum arc length in mm is, he wants to find arc length in mm. Okay, this question is wrong. Why? Because if you can see this relation, 20 plus 40 L, the maximum voltage attained by the welding machine is 80 volts only. For example, if you substitute value of L in 2 mm, let us say 2 mm only arc length, then what will happen? 80 plus 20, so it is overcoming, it is having higher value than open circuit voltage. It is not possible, it is wrong. And in the question, he is also mentioned that the arc length in centimeters. Okay, by somehow it is correct. Let us assume that thing. If arc length is 0.5, then the equation satisfies with our open circuit voltage. But 0.5 mm arc length cannot be maintained, because if surface having roughness, workpiece surface having roughness like this, if electrode is placed very near to the workpiece, that means I am maintaining 0.5 mm gap here at irregular point. What will happen? The electrode will touch with the workpiece and arc is gone. Arc will not be produced and it will stick with the workpiece and no welding operation can be carried out. So that's why 0.5 is incorrect. And then come to 1 mm. There is no difference between 0.5 and 1 mm. Very closer values, and we cannot maintain this 1 mm and 0.5 mm. Okay, so that's why this question is wrong. 0.5, it cannot be possible. 1 may be possible, but it cannot be possible with manual arc welding because of surface irregularities. Okay, this is the deepest concept of arc welding. And 5 mm, it is absolutely wrong, because if I substitute the 5 value in this equation, what will happen? The voltage is increasing than open circuit voltage, but we know that open circuit voltage is the maximum voltage that can be measured between two terminals without any loading condition. So it is the maximum and we cannot get much voltage than this. So if you substitute value of 5 in this, what will happen? It is overcoming that. So option C is also incorrect and option D is also incorrect. Okay, so what is the correct question? I am just replacing the values to get the right values. Okay, the same concept, I want to explain it to different values. You take this question, V is given by relation 24 plus 4 LA, and the open circuit voltage is given as 80 volts and short circuit current is given as 600 amperes. Now you find the optimum arc length for this question. Okay, we can solve this question. Whenever there is a optimum condition, what you have to do? The intuition behind this is for getting maximum power. For maximum power, what arc length should I have to maintain? So that is the meaning of optimum arc length. So I told you in the earlier problem solving session also, for maximum power, dp power, the variable here is arc length. Okay, the variable is arc length. In the previous questions, the variable is welding current or the variable is optimum voltage, but here the variable is arc length itself. So we have to differentiate power with arc length and equate that to zero. We will get the optimum arc length value something. Okay, so how can I do that? We know that power is given by VI, but I want to differentiate the power in variables of arc length. But in this equation, V and I, there is no LA term. So from this, V can be written as 24 plus 4 LA. Okay, one problem solved. 24 24 plus 4 La. Okay, now I. So there is no relation for I in the given question. So what I can do? I know that in the given question, somewhere he has to given straight line. Yes. The VI characteristics can be approximated by a straight line. That means it is a question of constant voltage. Okay. So we know that the equation of straight line with slope intercept can be written as V divided by VO plus I divided by IS equals 1. So I want to find the I value. Okay. So what I have to do? Just rearrange the terms. I will get I equals IS minus V by VO times of IS. Yes. Is it correct? Yes, it is. But this is also not in terms of LA. This is in terms of V. But I know V as 24 plus 4 LA. Just again substitute the value. So I equals IS is nothing but 600 amperes. So 600 minus V is nothing but 24 plus 4 LA divided by open circuit voltage is given by 80 and short circuit current is given as 600. Okay. Now I is in terms of LA and constant. So now I can substitute this value in above equation, in this equation. So I will get, this is very big equation. Just solve this equation very with peace mind. 24 plus 4 LA divided by 80 times of 600. Okay, so this is our big equation power in terms of length of arc only. There is no V term or I term. Only variable is arc length and those mean and remaining all are constants. So if I solve this equation, I will get P equals. Let me do that in my paper. Just a minute. 420 minus 30 LA and 634 LA 600 1080. So it will come out to be 10080 minus, let me slide this, sorry, plus 1680 LA minus 720 LA minus, what is this, 120 LA square. So this is the equation of power in terms of arc length only. So what I have to do, just to differentiate power with respect to arc length and equate that to 0. So this term will get 0 constant. So for this I can get 1680 minus 720 minus 240 LA and that term equal to 0. So I will get 240 LA equals 960. So from this LA equals 960 by 240 and that gives 40. So LA is 4 mm and that is our answer. Our given question is wrong, absolutely wrong, there is no doubt in that. So if something question like this comes in the exam, you do the same procedure. You find relation for V and I in terms of arc length, because the variable here is arc length. In the question he is finding, his intention is to find the optimum arc length. The optimum condition means for maximum power, how much arc length should I have to maintain. Okay, so that is the intuition behind this optimum arc length, and that's it. And now come to the next question, and that is the type of coated electrode most widely used for welding low carbon steels. We know that steel is having high affinity towards oxidation. So to provide it from oxidation, what we have to do, we have to form some slag layer or around that weld zone. So but the best way to add slag layer is rutile coating. In the previous question also I explained, rutile coating is used for slag formation. Okay, so that is the answer, repeated question in different manner. And now come to the next question, common data question. It is A weld is made using MIG welding process with the following welding parameters. Current is given as 200 amperes, voltage is given, welding speed is given, weld feed rate is given. Okay, here we have to use our consciousness. Current is given as 200, voltage is given as 25, and welding speed is given as 18 centimeter per minute. Okay, our conventions are mm per second. Okay, so but in the question his intention is to find kilojoule per centimeter, so I'm just using centimeter, but I'm converting the meter into minutes into seconds, 60 seconds. Okay, and that is our velocity, whatever it may be. And then come to the wire diameter. So the electrode diameter, nothing but is given as 1.2 mm. That's okay. Wire feed rate. Feed rate means what is the notation? Yes, you can use any. Tell me what is the notation? Any arbitrary notation like cross V. Okay. It is 4 meter per minute. So I want this in units of 4 centimeter per. Our diameter is given as mm, so I am just converting the wire dimensions into mm. Okay, so what I have to do, 4 into 1000 divided by 60 mm per second. Okay, and then compute the thermal efficiency of the process. Efficiency, that means heat transfer efficiency, is given as 65%, 0.65. The heat input per unit length of weld. So he is asking the heat, find heat input. So what is the formula for heat supplied or heat input? We know that Vi divided by Av times of heat transfer efficiency. So but in the question his intention is to find in kilojoule per centimeters. That means heat input per unit length. So area term can be neglected. Okay. And this is our final equation. So from this I will get V, I know 25, I also I know that is 200 divided by welding speed, that is 18 divided by 60 multiplied by heat transfer efficiency, that is nothing but 0.65. if I do that in my calculator, what I will get? 25 times 200 0.65 1860, so I got 10833.333. Okay, so this is my answer. The units are joule per centimeter because the units of welding speed are centimeter per second, so our answer is joule per centimeter. In the given question, kilojoule per centimeter, so that means it has to be divided by 1000 to get into kilojoules, and I get it as 10.83. so that is our answer. Answer C is correct. Now come to the second question. The area of cross section of the weld bed is, so his intention is to find area of cross section of weld bed. I know that from continuity equation, whatever the electrode is coming towards the weld zone, it has to fill the gap. It has to fill the gap between the two work pieces. So that is the concept here. So that means I am feeding this much diameter of electrode with this much of velocity into the blank space between the two work pieces. That means the blank space between the two work pieces is filled by the oncoming electrode. So let me draw the diagram to simplify the question. So this is the weld. Okay, these are two work pieces. I want to fill this gap. I want to fill this gap. So whatever electrode is coming towards the gap is melted and filling this gap. That means the continuity equation satisfies here. So what is continuity equation? A1 V1 equals A2 V2. So here the A1 V1 term relates to electrode and A2 V2 term relates to the gap. Okay, the gap. So he is asking the cross section of weld bead. So I have to find the cross section. That means this cross section, this much only, this much rectangle only. Okay, for example, if we assume it has a rectangular cavity. Okay, now come to the question. I know that area 1 of electrode, because the diameter is given. What is the diameter? 1.2 mm. So from this, area can be calculated as A1 pi by 4 d square, 1.2 square, and that will come out to be 1.1309 mm square, and V1 means nothing but the hash should be 4000 by 60 mm per second. Okay, V1 equals 66.666 mm per second. And from A2, so what is A2? That is the required thing. We have to find this. And V2, so that means velocity of weld, welding speed. Welding speed is given as, what is the welding speed? 18 by 60 centimeter per second. That means we have to convert the units into mm per second, because these all units are in mm. So please be careful with units convention. So 18 into 10 divided by 60 mm per second. So just substitute all these values in this continuity equation, and you will get area 2, that means area of weld bead, as 25.13 mm square. Is that in options? Yes, it is 25.1, close to our answer. 25.13, nothing but. So option B is correct. This is just a simple question. Just use the continuity equation. Whatever electrode is coming into the weld zone is filling the gap between the two work pieces. So the gap volume constraint we have to maintain here. So that means we have to use continuity equation. A1, B1 is terms related with electrode, and A2, V2 terms are related with the gap between the two work pieces. That means area of cross section times the velocity of weld. Here the velocity of workpiece, sorry, electrode. Okay, so that is our answer. And now come to the next question, that is, two 8 mm thick steel plates are placed 5 mm apart. So there are two steel plates, these are steel plates, are placed 5 mm apart. The distance between two plates are 5 mm. Okay, and welded by a butt joint. Welding is carried out at 20 volts and speed of 5 mm per second. So V is given as 20, and speed is given, and welding speed nothing but 5 mm per second. Units are okay. The heat transfer efficiency, arc heat transfer efficiency is given as 80%. If the heat required to melt is 10 joule per mm cube, that means heat required to melt is given as 10 joule per mm cube. Again the units are okay. And melting efficiency is given as, melting efficiency is 62.5%, that means 0.625. and he wants us to find the weld current in amperes. So the required thing is weld current. This is again a direct formula substitution. We know that melting efficiency is given by heat required to melt divided by heat supplied. Okay, and heat supplied can be multiplied by heat transfer efficiency if efficiency is given. So this is our formula. We know each and every term. Just substitute all the values. So melting efficiency is given as 0.625 equals heat required to melt is given as 10, and we know that heat supplied can also be written as VI divided by AV times heat transfer efficiency. Okay, so from this, V is given as 20, and I we have to find that divided by area. Oh my god, what is area? The gap is given. What is the thickness? Okay, sorry, thickness also given as 8 mm. 8 mm, okay. Now I can find the area as 5 times of 8. That means 40. Velocity is given as 5. Okay. And heat transfer efficiency is given as 0.8. Now from this equation, I can simply get value of I as, let me do that, 10 divided by 20 into 0.8, 0.625 divided by 200, that means I 200. So I becomes 200 amperes. So see the options. whether it is there or not. Yes, it is there. Option B matches with our answer. So option B is correct. Okay. Direct formula substitution. There is no need to think a lot much for this. Okay. Now come to the next question. Consider the following statements. The size of heat affected zone will increase with. So what is heat affected zone? I will explain here. It is a workpiece. And I am welding. This is the weld pool after solidification. Okay. So this is the reinforcement. We know that it is before solidification is liquid form. That means it is at high temperature. Because of this high temperature, because of thermal conductivity, the surrounding grains will also affected by the temperature. So that means the grain formation will be somewhat affected by the temperature. So that is called heat affected zone. Up to what distance it is affected, up to what distance the effect of heat is taking place. So that is nothing but heat affected zone. So this zone, all this area is called heat affected zone. Okay. Now come to the question. The heat size of heat affected zone will increase with increase starting temperature. Is it correct? Yeah, is it correct? It is correct. If starting temperature is high, then the heat effect zone will be high, definitely, because it is having more heat and increased welding speed. No, it is not correct. Why? Because if I increase the welding speed, I am not concentrating the heat at a constant single place for long durations. I am just short durations I am concentrating here because of high welding speed. So it is not correct. And increase thermal conductivity. Yes, it is correct. If I increase the thermal conductivity, the heat will be transferred very much faster to the edges. So that means if K value increases, the heat affected zone will also increases. So it is also correct. 1 and 3 are correct. Or option B is correct. Okay. Also read the fourth option. Increasing base metal thickness. There is no relation with thickness to heat affected zone. So that can be neglected. And 1 and 3 is correct. Now come to the next question. Autogenous gas tungsten arc welding of steel plate is carried out with welding current of 500 amperes. Write down the given data. Welding current is given as 500 amperes. Units are okay. Voltage of 20 volts. 20. Okay. And weld speed of 20 mm per minute. Units are not okay with me. Welding speed 20 mm per minute. But I told you that velocity units has to be in mm per second. So just convert that. 20 divided by 60 mm per second. Okay, now come to the question again. Consider the heat transfer efficiency from the arc to the weld pool is given as 90%. So heat transfer efficiency is given as 90%. 0.9. And the heat input per unit length in kilojoule per mm is. So he wants to find heat input, that means heat supplied. That is nothing but VI divided by AV times of heat transfer efficiency. But in the question, he is asking per unit length. That means area term can be neglected. Now units are correctly matched. Okay. Just substitute the all values, you will get answer. V is nothing but 20, I is 500. Divided by 20 by 60 multiplied with 90%. So I will get it as 20 will get cancelled, and 90% of 500 means 90% of 100 is 90, and 5 times means 45. That means 450. 450 times of 60 means 445 6 are 2700. That means 27,000. Okay. So this is your answer, but in the question kilojoule per mm is mentioned. So divided by 1000, that will give us 27 kilojoule per mm. Okay, so this is our answer. Option A is correct. Now come to the next question. Within the heat affected zone, in a fusion welding process, the work material undergoes. So I told you the heat affected zone is nothing but this all zone. Okay. What will happen in that zone? Microstructural changes but does not melt. Yes, it is correct. Microstructure will be changed, but the base metal will not melt over here. It is only melted over here. It is not melted over here, over this zone. Okay. And first option is correct. And then come to the next question. During a TIG welding process, the arc current and arc voltages are 50 amperes and 60 volts. So the current is given as 50 amperes and voltage is given as 60 volts. Very low current. Oh, okay. And when the welding speed was 150 mm per meter, welding speed is given as 150 mm per meter. I don't like the units, so I'm just converting this to mm per second. 150 mm per second. If you multiply it, divide it with 60, okay. And then come to in another process, same TIG welding, okay. We don't know current, and the welding speed is given 120 mm per minute. So I don't like this. 120 mm per second. If I divide this by 60, and what he say, arc voltage and heat supplied are same. That means I can equate heat supplied for process 1 with heat supplied for welding 2. So this is 1 and this is 2. Okay. From this, Vi by velocity equals Vi by velocity. V2, 2, 2. Okay. Now I want to find the welding current in second stage. In the question, voltage is same. Voltage terms can be cancelled. So from this, I2 becomes I1 divided by V1 multiplied with V2. So from this, I1 is nothing but 50. V2 is 120. There is no need to convert this to seconds because those will automatically cancel. So I'm not writing here. 120 divided by V1 is 150. 53 is 40. So our answer is option A, 40 amperes. And now come to the next question. In an arc welding process, the welding speed is doubled. Assuming welding speed is 2 times doubled, okay. Assuming all other processes parameters to be constant, all other are constant, the cross section area of the weld bead will be, okay, the what will be the cross section area? That means all other processes are parameters are constant. That means power also constant. That means heat supplied will also constant. So what will happen to the area when the welding speed will gets doubled? We know that again formula, heat supplied is given by Vi divided by Av times efficiency. So all other remaining terms are constant. That means power also has to be constant. That's why if welding is doubled, to neutralize this equation back to the original, what I have to do? I just reduce the area by half. Then only these two will be gets cancelled and I will get same answer. Okay. So that's why area has to be reduced to half if welding speed is doubled. Then only the equation will be balanced. Otherwise the heat supply will increase or will decrease. So but in the question he said that all other process parameters to be constant. So to make that heat supply constant, if welding speed is doubled, then area has to be reduced to half. Then only that will be balanced. So our answer is the cross section area of weld bead will decrease by 50%. Yes, it is the answer. Reduced by 50%. And then come to next question. Okay, over. All questions are over. And that's it. Thank you.